Ladies, gentlemen, boys, and girls, baseball fans of all ages, hello and welcome into the Tom Graham Diamond at Memorial Field for today's MIAA Division 4 South Shore League matchup. It is the Middleborough Sachems coming up Route 18 to face your Abington Green Wave. As always, I'm Mad Dog Matt Nelson bringing you all of the action. This one is fouled off out of play. It's 1-1 to Nate Goodill. He'll be followed in the Sachems lineup by Ryan Marzoli, Braden Wright, Dan Muskie, Tyler Zamara, TJ Wanky. Jeremy Nee will bat seventh. Zach Iwanski is batting eighth. Nelly Figueredo hitting ninth. They'll face the Green Wave defense of Steven Madden on the hill. Senior throws one in the zone that gets sent out to left field. John Sellen moving over, and he will make the catch for the first out. Cam Cooper is doing the catching. A.J. Nash at first. Jake Central at second. Henry Rogers is the shortstop. Colin Crocker at third. Ryan Solomini, John Sellen, Pat Cummings left to right across the outfield. Here is Ryan Marzoli. Madden finds strike two with a sweeper. Did miss the Tachi Volin told you for tomorrow? Yes. Fly ball out to Solomini, and he makes the grab. There's two away. Braden Wright is the Sachem's pitcher. We'll bat in the three hole. He looks at a first pitch curve for strike one. Right at the front of the box. We'll look at ball two inside, 2-1. Big swing and a miss, evens the count 2-2. To Wright, trying to help his own cause, two away at the top of the first. This one is lined out to right center field. It'll drop in front of Sellen. And it's a two-out single for the Sachems pitcher. Now Dan Muskie, the third baseman, steps in. 38. Healthy lead at first for Wright. He'll hold. The curve misses outside. One fouled off, out of play, a ball and a strike. Madden, the Nichols College Bison commit, pitch at the Division III level. Another nasty curve. 1-2. Mara takes off. The pitch is ball high and outside. The throw down is ahead of the bag. And Wright has a stolen base. Madden will call for Cooper to meet him for a word with the 2-2 count. Oh, 2-2 from Madden. The curve blown away. Four is low. We'll put runners back on first and second for Tyler Zamara. First pitch Zamara sees is fouled off. Good for strike one for Madden. Curve misses inside. Madden's 21st pitch of the afternoon. Big swing and a miss and a fastball. Gets ahead, a ball and two strikes. Madden shakes off the first couple from Cooper. Now we'll reset. Ends 1-2. Sweeper outside. Green Wave trying to shake a three-game losing streak. So the 2-2 Madden will step off. Foul ball could be playable. It's going to tail out behind the Sachems dugout. Abington falling 9-4 to Sandwich last week. That was after 5-3 loss to Norwell. 1-0 decision against East Bridgewater. Now the batter, Zamara, asks for time. Two, another nasty curve, and that is another one that's fouled off into the parking lot. Another 2-2. Another one that Zamara was behind into the parking lot, 2-2. Curve is up and in. Full count. Here's the payoff pitch. Just missed over the outside corner. And that will load him up. Base is juiced for TJ Wanky. Wanky fouls off the first offering.
Hey, give me some balls in there.
Your A lot of foul balls. And we'll have a quick restock. Nice sweeper. Good for strike two. Madden ahead. No balls, two strikes. Trying to leave him loaded here in the top of the first. Here's the 0-2. Another one fouled off and out of play. Another 0-2. Just getting a piece of that was Winky. At the very tip of the end of the bat. Another one sent out of play to the right side. This one skips up, and Middleborough will find the board first on the wild pitch. Samara up to second, Mosley to third. This one sent to center field, charging in is Sellen, and he'll make the grab to end the inning, but Middleborough gets one, and they leave two stranded, 1-0 Sachems as we head to the bottom of the first inning. Ryan Solomini will lead off the Green Wave batting order. Pat Cummings, Steve Madden do up 2-3. A.J. Nash in cleanup. John Sellen bats fifth. Henry Rogers sixth. Cam Cooper will step in seventh. Jake Central eighth. Colin Crocker is batting ninth. Solomini. We'll look at strike one. Solomini back-to-back Abington home run derby champion. He won it yesterday. One is upstairs, 2-0. 2-1, excuse me. Green Wave chasing the one run. Three balls, one strike now. Full count for Braden Wright. Solomini will look at a nasty curve over the outside corner, and there's one away. There's Pat Cummings. Pat Cummings is a speedy right fielder. Looks at one in the dirt, 1-1. Strike two over the outside edge. Right ahead of the count now. Cummings will leave that one up and out. Right the southpaw. 2-2 is strike three. Bend it over the inside corner. Now it'll be Steve Madden. Madden always likes to take the first offering at the dish. Does just that, 0-1. That one well outside. Right, it's motion ball. Is working early here. Beautiful day for baseball. Madden will line this one out into right center field. It drops in for the Green Wave's first hit. AJ Nash changing up the look today instead of the knee-high socks, wears his pants down all the way to his cleats. Trying to shake the momentum, and he lines it out to right field, jumping backwards to make the grab. And that will retire the side. A nice play by Tyler Zamara. And the Green Wave will leave one stranded in the bottom of the first, 1-0. Middleborough on top as we head to the second. Jeremy Nee, Zach Iwanski, Nelly Figueredo do up for the Middleborough Sachems, the 7-8-9 hitters. Madden back on the hill for a second inning of work. He is the Sachem's DH. It's a hard liner through the left side and into left field for a base knock. Crocker in on the grass, expecting bunts. Swinging away was Iwanski. Well, behind that one was Iwanski, 1-2. Fouled off, 2-2. No one just missed low. Full count.
Nice pitch, Steven.
Here's the payoff for men. Runner takes off. It's ball four. Nelly Figueredo is the Middleborough catcher. He sends this one out to Sellen. He'll make the jump and grab on the liner. No chance for a tag. There's one away. Top of the order for Nate Goodall. He flew out deep to Sellen in the first inning. Whoa, big offering and a miss by Goodall. Throw down to second is stopped nicely by Rogers. Centrella there is another layer. Fouled off, full count. Another ball four will load the bases. Corner infielders in with the bases loaded, just the one out. High pop fly, Crocker in foul territory. Lost it drifting back. Ryan Marzoli flew to left his first time up. Pops it straight back to the pitcher's mound. Infield fly rule is called, and that'll be the second out. Wright has scored the game's only run so far. He is the Middleborough pitcher. 1-0 his first time up. Up Liner to Solomini. He'll dive and make the catch. What a grab by Ryan Solomini in left to end the inning and leave the Middleborough bases loaded in the top of the second. It's still 1-0 Middleborough, courtesy of Ryan Solomini making a phenomenal diving catch. We head to the bottom of the second. Bottom of the second inning, we'll see John Sillen, Henry Rogers, and Cam Cooper come to the plate. Green waiver chasing one. Sillen will leave that one up. Knuckleball is sent into right field, and it'll be a single base for John Sillen. Crazy looking knuckleball from Braden Wright. Ground ball to short, could be two. The flip to second. The throw to first is not going to be in time. Rogers beats it out. Fielder's choice for Rogers. That'll bring up Cam Cooper. Cooper lines it back through the middle. Great diving stab, but in and out of the glove, the runners will be safe. Meanwhile, we have a good start to the inning. Figueredo to have a word with Wright. Corners on the edge of the grass for Centrella. And leaves ball one outside. Right, targeting that outside edge against Centrella. Centrella lines it into left field, and Coach Spraxis is going to wave around Rogers. Here's the throw. It's offline. Rogers scores, and now the ball being at the backstop will advance the runners up to second and third. It's Centrella with the Green Wave's first RBI. All knotted at one. That'll bring up Cullen Crocker with one away. Runners on second and third. It's Cooper on third. Centrella on second. Missing high. Two balls, one strike. That one will miss low and away. Three balls, one strike now to Crocker. Top of the order in Ryan Salamini waiting on deck. And that'll be ball four. So now the Sachems in the jam. Base is juiced one away. Top of the green wave order. Salamini in there now. Cummings on deck. Salamini will look at strike one. Fouled off the catcher's mask to the backstop. Ball and two strikes. Popped up right side. And no one's going to get there. Falls in fair territory. And now the throw to second gets through. That's into left field. Centrella's in. Two runs score. On what should be a single. And then a series of errors leaves the green wave with a 3-1 lead. And runners on second and third. Cummings swinging through strike one. Three-run inning here in the bottom of the second for the Green Wave, looking to add more. Cummings a hard liner down the right field line. Foul. Blooper to center field. And the throw is going to be ahead of Crocker. And he is out at home plate on the inning-ending double play. But the Green Wave answer. They lead it 3-1, headed to the top of the third. Dan Mosley, Tyler Zamara, TJ Wanky do up for the Sachems. They're now chasing two runs after giving the Green Wave three in the bottom of the second. Three balls, one strike. Count to Mosley. It's the payoff pitch. little bloop off the handle, and Nash will take it himself. Zamara walked his first time up. To an order Zamara. And catching the bottom end of the zone, full count. Here's the 3-2. Fouled off. Ground ball just under the glove of Madden. Centrella stabs it. Nice spin around. Shot to first is in time for the out. Here's TJ Wanky. He flew out to Sillen and center to end the first inning. Three and 0 the count to Wanky. Madden now above 70 pitches on the afternoon. Wanky swung at one that was up above the zone to load the count. Still full, third consecutive batter with a payoff pitch. And Madden wins it to end the inning. 1-2-3 in order go the Sachems. In the top half of the third, it's 3-1 Abington as we head to the bottom of the third when we come back. Madden singled his last time up. Him, Nash, and Sellen go up for the green wave here in the bottom of the third. Madden will be 2-for-2. Nash flew to right his first time up. Will hit a hard grounder between shortstop and third this time. The green wave aggressive to start the inning. Two first pitch swings. Two first pitch singles. And here's John Sullen, who singled himself his first time up. Sullen looks at a curveball inside. Two and oh. Curve catches the outside corner. Outside ball three. Right in a little bit of a jam to start the third. Sullen hits a grounder to first, and the only play is to the bag. Move the runners up on the sacrifice. Henry Rogers reached on a fielder's choice his first time up. A chopper. Throw to first is in time and no advance. Here's Cooper. He singled his last time up. Two on, two out for the green wave. The bottom half of the third. Two on two from right. There's a high to even the count at two and two. Hey, two. 2-2 to that was fouled off and definitely just hit my car. It's either me or Miss Reed. 2-2. That one sent the other way to left field, drifting back and making the catch. That'll end the inning and get the Sachems out of the jam. Green Wave leave them stranded on second and third. They still lead it 3-1 as we head to the fourth. Jeremy Nee, the designated hitter, will lead off. Sakowanski and Nelly Figueredo also do up. The 7-8-9 hitters in the Sachem lineup.
One more walk, Steven, through the catcher. Through the catcher, Steven.
Ball on a strike to Knee. He singled his last time up.
There you go. Go there again. Go,
One, two, fouled off. Chopper towards Crocker. The throw is in time. Nice stretch by Nash. Zakowanski walked his last time up. Curveball finds inside corner 0 and 2 now to Iwanski. Chopper to third. Crocker plays it. Throw over is in time. And again, a nice stretch by Nash. Two away. Middleborough coach thinks that Nash was off the bag and he'll go seek an explanation. Now Coach Praxis wanting an explanation as the overturned call would leave Iwanski safe at first, saying Nash's foot was off the bag. So Wonski is going to be safe at first on the single. That will bring up Figueredo for the Sachems. Healthy lead at first for Iwanski. He'll hold as Figueredo looks at strike one. Chopper, Madden will take it himself and he'll toss to first for the second out. Goodall walked and flew out to center. Fly ball, drifting foul. Solomini over, tried to make the diving catch. Couldn't quite come up with that one. Excellent effort. for the Green Wave left fielder. Throw down to second. Rogers able to get there nicely. Strike on Goodall, thought it was ball four. Foul ball towards left, Solomini won't have a play at that one. There's another payoff. And that is ball four. Ryan Marzoli has flown to left and popped back to Madden at the pitcher's mound. Green Wave have two outs here in the top half of the fourth. Ball and a strike to Marzoli. This one sent towards left center. Sellin drifting back. He won't be able to get there. Catches on the bare hand. Two Middleborough runs score. And it's an RBI double for Marzoli to tie the game up at three. Call it first. Now looming large. This one rocket towards center. Sellin back will make the catch. Midair to retire the side, but not before Middleborough answers in a big way. It's tied up at three. Jake Centrella will lead off the bottom of the fourth. Single run scored his first time up.
No.
Three balls, one strike. The count to Centrella. Count loads up for Centrella. It's a walk for Centrella. That'll bring up Crocker. Strike one to Crocker. Walk in his last at bat. Throw to first, Centrella in safe. Crocker's bunt attempt fouled to the backstop. Crocker's off blooper through second base. Defensive swing with two strikes and a successful one. I'll bring up the top of the order in Ryan Solomini. Solomini 1-for-2, single his last time up. Solomini drops down a nice bunt. The speedy left fielder beats it out. They're safe all around. Bunt single for Ryan Solomini brings up Pat Cummings. With no outs, the bases are loaded for the Green Wave. Nice block behind the dish by Figueredo. That one catches the inside corner.
I like mac and cheese.
Cummings rockets out to left center field. Centrella's going to score easy. Here comes Crocker. Solomini is going to get held at third. It's a two-run double for Pat Cummings. Green Wave back on top, 5-3. Down, That's going to be the day for Braden Wright. Pitching change for the Sachems here in the bottom of the fourth inning. It's 5-3 Abington. The new Middleborough pitcher is Trevor Dillon. He will be taking the place in the lineup of TJ Wenke, who has now exited with Wright taking first base. It'll be Steve Madden, his first opponent. Madden pops him up, foul territory, right field side. No one's going to get there.
If not right there is why we practice pop-up, so that doesn't happen.
Ball and two strikes. And leaves the curveball outside. Madden liner through, and Cummings is going to round the corner with the ball by the left fielder. It's a two-run single for Steve Madden. Tough play. Nash is out at first. That'll bring up Sellen. Ground ball to second for Sellen. Hops in and out of the glove, and Sellen's going to beat it out. Madden, meanwhile, hustled up to third. Runners on the corners with one out. Here's Henry Rogers. He's reached on a fielder's choice and grounded to third, one for two. Nice bunt drop down by Rogers. It hits on the line. It stays fair. The run scores. Sellen up to second. Perfect bunt by the St. Michael's College commit. Purple Knights in the NCAA Division II high level of play. In the Northeast 10 Conference. St. Mike's getting a good one with Rogers. That brings up Cam Cooper, the ninth Green Wave member, to bat this inning. And he'll foul off the first pitch. Eight to three, the Green Wave adding five runs here in the bottom of the fourth. Dillon's going to step off. Ball and a strike to Cooper. Two and one. Still just one out here in the bottom of the fourth. Pitch is behind the catcher, and the runners will move up. Selling at third, Rogers up to second. Infield in as Cooper looks at strike two. Cooper hard liner foul. Count still full. Ball four. Bases juiced for Jake Centrella, who walked his first time up this inning. He singled back in the second. Scored two runs in his two previous plate appearances. Notably popped that absolute missile of an RBI double back in the state semifinal last spring. Look to further help his team's cause. 0-2, the count to Centrella. Second baseman is overshifted towards the bag on the edge of the outfield grass. Here's the 0-2, and that's a high ball one. The 2-2 to Centrella. Hard grounder foul, so it had to dance around it. Colin Crocker's on deck. Another foul on a pretty nasty curveball from Dylan. Centrella high fly ball, left field. Selling takes off, he's gonna beat this out easily. Throw cut off, it's 9-3 Green Wave. On the sacrifice fly ball from Centrella. Here's Crocker. He has reached twice in his two previous plate appearances, a walk and a single. Low and in ball one. Crocker lose ball two up out of the zone. Hey, Crocker right up the middle, lines it into center field, and then it takes a weird hop. Rogers is going to score. RBI single for Cullen Crocker. Weird hop out there in center field, in and out of the glove of the Sachem center fielder. And that makes it 10-3, Abington on top. For the top of the order, Ryan Solomini, 2-for-3, two singles. And a look at ball one well out of the zone. Solomini, the reigning, defending, two-time Abington Baseball Home Run Derby champion. Repeating his title for the second time yesterday. In the dirt, the runners will take off, throw to third. And the umpire, who was behind the pitcher's mound, says that Cooper was out at third as Middleborough clears the field. Caught stealing the call. So we've hit the end of the fourth inning. Green Wave at 7. They lead 10-3. Mosley is 0-for-1. He also walked back in the first. Faces Madden on the hill for his fifth inning of work. Green Wave's only perfect inning was the third. They set the Sachems down 1-2-3 in order. You never know what you're going to see in baseball. That one hit the power line and then fell onto the roof of my car. Second foul ball copped by the Mad Dog Mobile today. Swing and a miss in the dirt. Cooper will have to throw it down to first as a formality in plenty of time. There's one away. Strike one to Tyler Zamara, who has walked and grounded to Centrella at second. Oh, and two. Chopper goes foul, still 0-2. Another strikeout. Yeah, This will be Trevor Dillon, his first at bat since taking over for right on the mound. Another foul ball ahead, Hunter, 1-2. Madden now at the 115 pitch limit, so this will be his last batter. 2-2. Full count. Payoff is ball four. So we will have a pitching change here for the Green Wave. It will be Henry Rogers on the hill for the Green Wave. They lead a 10-3. When we come back, we'll go over all the Green Wave's defensive changes here in the top of the fifth. So Madden and Rogers switch one for one. Pitcher and shortstop trading places. Madden will be tested immediately. His throw to first is well offline and now out of play. The runners will move to second and third. This one will get out of play, 0-2. Rogers up 0-2 on Zach Iwanski. Two balls, two strikes. Still 2-2. Ground ball to short, Madden. This throw on the money, and Madden ultimately closes the book on himself, leaves the two runners stranded, and we head to the bottom of the fifth inning, Abington leading 10-3. Bottom of the fifth inning, we'll start with the top of the order, Ryan Solomini, Pat Cummings, and Steve Madden. Solomini 2 for 3, 2 singles. will look at that wild pitch go to the backstop. It is still Trevor Dillon on the hill for the Sachems. Dillon evens the count 2-2. That'll be ball 3 upstairs. Still 2-2 to Solomini. And he will go down by way of the K. Pat Cummings now, a 2-run double his last time up. Popped up, first base side. And drifting back was right. That'll bring up Madden, who's 3-for-3 with 3 singles. Looks at a pretty nasty moving curve. Man lines a foul. Outside ball 1, or ball. The pitch to Madden. And that'll catch the outside corner for strike 3. That'll end the 5th, 3-up, 3-down for the Green Wave. And we will head to the top of the 6th. Abington up, 10-3. Nelly Figueredo will lead off the Sachems half of the 6th. It'll be the 9-1-2 hitters. Facing Henry Rogers. Number off the end of the bat goes foul. Popped up. Madden drifting over. We'll make the catch in front of Crocker. So here's Nate Goodell. He's walked twice and flown to center. Rogers, a nice sweeper. Catches the zone for strike one. Fly ball, Cummings in right, sizing it up. Comes in about 5 feet and makes the catch for the second out. Ryan Marzoli, 1 for 3, a double his last time up. Ground ball, Nash had it kick up and off his elbow. Be a two-out single for Marzoli. Here's Braden Wright, popped a single back in the first. He's flown to left and to center field. Fouls it off the very end of the bat. Runner takes off, no throw. Lined towards Cummings. He'll stick the glove out and make a phenomenal catch to end the inning. The Green Wave outfield has been phenomenal today, and that continues with Pat Cummings making the highlight reel catch to strand a runner in scoring position and send it to the bottom of sixth with the Green Wave still up 10-3. A.J. Nash, John Sell, and Henry Rogers do up in the Green Wave sixth. Nash takes strike one from Trevor Dillon on for his third inning of work. One-one. It's a high ball, too. Three and one the count to Nash. It's a 5-pitch walk to Nash. Selling 1 for 3. Ball one high. That curve missing outside, 2-0. Come on, Sellen pops it to center. Still going back. It's well over his head. Nash is going to score easy. Sellen's heading for third. The ball finally tracked down. Sellen is going to get waved around. He's going to score the throw off line. It's an inside the park home run for John Sellen. And that puts the Green Wave within one run of the mercy rule. What a pop for John Sellen. Here's Henry Rogers. Green Wave will be down in Hyannis on Friday night. Playing in a Cape League field as they take on the Pope John Paul Lions. Two and one the count to Rogers. Sun set behind the Frollo School, entire field shaded now. Rogers loops it to shallow right center. And it is second baseman drifting back to make the play. For the first out, here's Cam Cooper. He's walked, singled, and flown to deep left. One and one. Jake Centrella on deck. Trevor Dillon, the 3-1. Is lines into the glove. And there's two away. Here's Centrella. He has walked, singled, and hit a bomb of a sacrifice. One, two on Centrella. Here's the 1-2 from Dillon. It's a high ball, evens the count. Centrella looks at a fastball over the outside corner, strike three. We will head to the top half of the seventh inning. Middleborough needs nine to see the bottom half. It's 12-3 Abington. It'll be the 4-5-6 hitters to up for the Sachems here in the top half of the seventh inning. Dan Mosley lines it out into left field. It'll drop in for a base hit. Tyler Zamora is 0 for 2 with a walk. Ground ball to Madden, double play ball. Centrella didn't have a throw to first. Here is Middleborough's new pitcher, Trevor Dillon. Dillon ducks out of a high and inside, ball one. That one past Cooper. Make it two balls, one strike to Dillon. This one popped to center field. Sellin drifts over and makes the grab for the second out. Here's Jeremy Nee. He has singled, grounded out to third. And reached on an error. Big swing and a miss. One and one. Sachems are down to their last strike. The 1-2 from Rogers misses outside, evens the count. Two balls, two strikes. Curveball swing and a miss, strike three, and the Green Wave get back in the win column in a big way, defeating the Sachems 12-3. And an impressive comeback as they were down early in this one. It is Henry Rogers coming in for the last four innings, relieving Steve Madden. John Sellin with a home run to add the insurance run in the bottom of the sixth. 12-3 again, the final. The Sachems fall to the Abington Green Wave, who break that three-game losing streak and are back in the win column before their road trip down to the Cape. 12-3, the final from Tom Graham Diamond. Today, I want to thank our phenomenal crew, Aiden and Nathan, our executive producer, Kevin Tachi. On behalf of everyone here at Abington Community Access and Media, I'm Mad Dog Matt Nelson. And we will see you next game.